In part one, we covered how to name alkanes when given the structure. So if you missed that, you can find that video here. Now we'll go over how to draw the structure when given the name. Here's the format of each example name we will go over. Notice how in each example, we always have a number in front of our substituent followed by the longest carbon chain. That number tells us which carbon that specific substituent is located at. We'll always start with drawing the longest carbon chain first, then placing the substituents at the correct locations. Let's do three different examples that increase in difficulty. Here's example one. Step one, draw the longest carbon chain. I have a trick on how to draw the correct carbon chain each time. Count to one less than the number of carbons you want. Say we wanted to draw only 8 carbons. If we counted to 8 when drawing, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, that actually gives you 9 carbons. But if we count to 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that gives us 8 carbons, which is what we wanted. So we will do the same for this example since it states octane and we know that's 8 carbons. Step 2, number the carbon chain. We can number the carbon chain either from left to right or right to left. I'll number it from left to right. Step 3, place substituents at their designated numbers. In this case, we only have one substituent located at the 4th carbon on our carbon chain. Remember, propyl has 3 carbons, so this is the structure for 4-propyl octane. Here's example 2. Step 1, draw the longest carbon chain. Our longest carbon chain is pentane, pent meaning 5. Let's draw 5 carbons, remembering the trick where we count to 1 less than the number of carbons we want. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and we actually drew 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons. Step 2, number the carbon chain. I'll number the carbon chain from left to right, but you could have numbered it from right to left. Step 3. Place substituents at their designated numbers. We have 2 different substituents in this case, an ethyl group and a methyl group. Both groups are located at the 3rd carbon. This is one way we could have drawn the structure. We could have also drawn the major carbon chain going up first and placed the same substituents. Either way, both examples have the substituents at carbon 3, so they both are correct. Now for our more challenging example, example 3. Step 1. Draw the longest carbon chain. Our longest carbon chain is butane, but meaning 4, so we'll draw 4 carbons. So 1, 2, 3, and we drew 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. Step 2, number the carbon chain. I'll number the carbon chain from left to right. Step 3, place substituents at their designated numbers. Whenever we have a number, then a comma, followed by another number, this tells us that there's more than one of the same substituent. In this case, we have 4 numbers plus the prefix of tetra, and tetra means 4, so we must have 4 methyl groups since this is tetramethyl. Our numbers in front tell us we have 2 methyl groups on carbon 2 and 2 methyl groups on carbon 3, and this is the proper structure. Now, if you would like help on your homework, online tutoring, or other helpful resources, I have all of that and more in the description box. And remember, stay determined, you can do this.